Now I was dreaming about a deal at the age of 13.
What's up, you guys? Welcome back to Mad Medicine. My name is Farhan. I am a medical student, and today we're going to be discussing if doctors and medical professionals should be on TikTok. Now, before we talk about that, let me show you guys something that my wife bought. Recently, she bought this label maker because she got tired of being at home during quarantine, and she wanted to reorganize our pantry, and she did exactly that. Let me show you how many things she has now labeled with this dope little label maker.
So these are all of our seasonings, and she has clearly labeled all of them.
Yeah, I think this is a pretty cool label maker. It's a lot of fun, and I want to label everything around the house, but obviously I can't. If you guys want to get it, there's a link in the description below. It's pretty cheap. I think it's like $10 or $11. But right now, let me make some coffee, and after coffee, we're going to sit down and let's talk about whether or not doctors should be on TikTok. So I got my coffee. Let's talk about whether or not doctors should be on TikTok. I get asked this quite often, not just online, but in person as well. And if you guys don't know what TikTok is the newest social media platform that's out there where people can upload only videos that are up to a minute long, and you can scroll through different types of videos very easily, very quickly. It's a very interesting platform, and I'm on TikTok as a medical student, and somehow I've been able to get a following on TikTok. If you don't follow me, check me out. So before we talk about this question, before we answer this question, we need to first discuss what the role of a medical professional is in society. And at the end of the day, it's very simple. A medical professional, whether you are a doctor or a medical student or a nurse, whatever it may be, your role is to help people. Period. That's it. It's to help people. And in society, we know, especially nowadays, society is changing, but at the same time, social media has become a very integral part of our society. You can't separate society from social media anymore. It's the same. So with that being said, is it important for doctors to be on social media? Yes. And should doctors or medical professionals be on TikTok? Absolutely. And I'm going to tell you why right now. Like I said earlier, the role of a medical professional in society is to help people. That's what their role is, right? And there are many different ways you can help people. Doctors do different things to help people, and it can really vary. But one way you can help people online, especially through social media, is by educating people. And that's what doctors do on a daily basis. When they see patients, they educate those patients on how to better take care of themselves, whether it's with what you eat or what you do. And the doctors who I follow online, they're actually doing a very, very good job on educating their following of their, educating their fan base on how to better take care of themselves. I follow some psychiatrists, I follow some oncologists, some podiatrists, and they are giving very good health information online for people who are interested. I think that's very important. So number one, it's very important for doctors to be on TikTok because it is a very good way to educate people. Number two, there's also a lot of fake information that's on social media, right? A lot of people claim that certain techniques, certain waters, or certain things will detoxify your liver, which is not true, okay? There's a lot of fake medical information that's out there that's not based in science. It's completely false, often fabricated, and because the people who are peddling this information end up having a following, a lot of people think it's actually a true fact when it's not. This is very dangerous because some people might take that as actual medical information. Some people might think that it is real information and follow that information rather than the guidelines or the recommendations of their physicians and end up harming themselves. That's why doctors have to be on social media to combat this false information. And again, the doctors who I follow on TikTok, who I have seen, are doing exactly that. They're essentially preventing the dissemination of false information. And at the same time, they're actually presenting very accurate information that's based in science that is proven, which is very, very important to understand. So that's why they're very important on TikTok. They're taking care of that community in a sense. And then finally, you gotta realize that medical careers, whether you're a nurse or a doctor, are very stressful. They are very stressful. They take a lot from you. It's very taxing emotionally, physically, mentally. And TikTok is a very great platform for you to just unwind, watch some funny videos, watch some informative videos, and watch some educational videos, and, you know, relax a little. And for them to be online, for certain people like me, I'm on TikTok because it's a great way for me to enjoy what I'm doing, be creative, and be able to have some time to decompress. And that's the same for a lot of physicians, a lot of medical professionals who are on TikTok. They just enjoy the platform. So at the end of the day, I think it's very important for physicians, for doctors, for nurses to be on these platforms if they're disseminating very good, accurate information and taking care of people and educating people. That's what I'd like to do. I like to make educational videos where I can inform people of crazy medical facts about their bodies or things that don't belong in your body and just fun, informative things. But at the same time, a lot of doctors are also not just educating, they're also spreading accurate information on like the coronavirus or what's going on in systemic racism in healthcare. It's very interesting. It's a great platform. So to answer the question, should doctors be on TikTok? Yes. Absolutely. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. If you guys don't follow me already on TikTok, go ahead and check me out at Mad Medicine. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel on YouTube because your support really means a lot to me. Thank you again, and I'll see you guys back here real soon.